This person has got things to do. He knows what he's doing. He knows what he wants to achieve.
Hello, welcome to my YouTube channel, Jessica Inonge Machwani. And yes, I have company. Today I have my very close friend, and behind the scene we have my little brother who is actually capturing us, and next time he will be featured also. We'll have a nice conversation with him. Mm-hmm. And when he's not shy, obviously. Mm-hmm. Yes. So like I said, I have company. This is my friend, a very close friend of mine, Cherry Beauty Piri, but I call her Fruits because of the cherries.
What I'm supposed to talk about here is what?
Men.
Yes. The best. I can talk about that nicely with confidence.
Like I said, it's going to be flowing. So you are somebody who is educated. Mm-hmm. And when we talk about women who are educated, that's different. Okay, there is just this way that women who are educated pick men. Mm-hmm. So obviously you can't just pick any random guy.
No.
Yeah. So what kind of a guy would you actually say this is my man?
A guy that has sense.
Please don't say that.
A guy that a guy that has got goals. Mm-hmm. A guy that has got a future. Mm. He knows what he wants, and a guy who's got money.
Yeah, that's clever.
And a guy who's got good hygiene.
Nice combination there. So, if you would meet that person with those qualities, would he also find the same in you?
Yes.
Okay. So, there is this interesting story about Regina Daniels. You know about it, right?
Yeah.
So, would you say she was right to leave her boyfriend, although he was also working like her? Or was she right or was she wrong about it?
It's a 50-50 thing.
If you were in her shoes?
I would have done it as well.
That is not a 50-50.
No! Mm-hmm. If I was in her shoes, I would have done it as well. Mm-hmm. Kylie, she was looking at the money. Mm-hmm. Okay, she's just a gold digger, let me just say so.
She said that if you only talk about love but you can't prove it in ways, then it's better you go. Mm-hmm. And all right, I believe it's not being a gold digger to love a better life for yourself, because as it is, she started at a very young age being an actress, and then whatsoever that she went through or whatsoever that she has seen people going through, she didn't want that for herself, for her children. So it was just very much okay. Because it's not like it's a sin for you to actually want a better life for yourself. So what she did was to show this guy that I'm not trying to get you in my life so that I waste time with you. Better, my dear, you find yourself somebody else who's going to stay with you. And like, you get married, you start cheating simply because someone else has better money than your husband. So she obviously did a good thing. And which leads me to this. Do you think it's fine to continue being with a man that you know that I'm available to be with the end?
No.
Why?
No. Why? Because you've seen the future, you know that this person has no goals, he has no plans, no future plans. So why would you stay with someone like that? People are supposed to have goals. You need to see the potential in someone, to say this person has got things to do, he knows what he's doing, he knows what he wants to achieve. So if you can't see that in a person, you can't stay with that person.
Yeah. Okay. And if you have come a long way and you have been with this person who does not cheat, and he has money and he is well doing, those qualifications that you already mentioned, they are there, and then suddenly like things go bad to a point whereby he can't afford the things that he used to buy, but then he's just like affording basic things. He's just on an average kind of a thing now. But things are not as they were before. Would you leave him or would you stay?
He had money.
Mm-hmm.
Then now he loses some of it and now he's average.
Yes.
I wouldn't leave him.
Hmm. Okay. And then he's an underdog. Would you make sure that you rise with him?
It depends on the same goals and potential we're talking about. Because if he doesn't have that potential, no potential, you can't be someone without vision. But if he's at least, you can then see that, okay, this person is trying, you can try to compromise.
Okay. Give me three reasons why you think are the causes of gender-based violence.
Lack of money.
Anyway, so
because
you cancel people.
Me, I don't cancel people.
You don't do that.
That's
what do you do? Whosoever saw negativity, they shall not pass. We are gonna leave them somewhere in the bushes. Okay. So, on my part, I believe that gender-based violence, some of the causes are... they are... Being an abuser of alcohol is also one of the things. Yes, drug abuse. So, is also one of the things that causes gender-based violence. If you are a substance abuser and you don't know how to control that, it would be negative on your family. Yeah. So, when was that woman such a bit of HIV? So, how would you advise youths being safe, keeping themselves safe?
Well, my advice to pupils only, for everyone in general, just pupils.
Let's first talk about pupils, because one is it.
Okay. So advise pupils to abstain. They should abstain, because it's going to prevent them from getting HIV, another sexually transmitted infections, and also unwanted pregnancy. Because most of the time these days we're having pupils and all that are getting pregnant. So I don't know why these people find it funny. So yeah, they should abstain. And if they want to do it too.
Listen, there is this thing. Do you remember our civic education teacher?
Mr. Okalando.
He told us that if I tell you don't do it, you're still going to do it. You're going to do it.
So,
while doing it, do this instead. So, what she's trying to say is that she's speaking for herself. No, everyone keep safe. But she basically knows that it's a true fact. There will be peer pressure. There will be obsession, which most teenagers go through. So, it will not be easy for a pupil to actually just keep themselves safe. So instead of just falling in and not being safe, they should rather use protection.
Nice.
So carry that as a guarantee that you'll be safe. But otherwise, it is not right. Know it within yourself that it's wrong. What would be your advice to pupils who go under peer pressure?
Jessica! It's like the guy who early. You guys peer pressure when you're hanging around school. After class hours. You're going to be... immediately you leave class. You go home. That's one way to avoid peer pressure.
Okay.
The other one, keep good friends. Keep normal friends. There are friends that come from different backgrounds. So there are people where you can see, I thought this one is serious in school. Those are the friends to keep around. If you see a person who's always playful all the time, you want to dodge.
So thank you for coming and thank you for making this video. Yes, I'm so, so thankful. Even though you're not feeling well, you made an effort to come and show me your beauty. Thank you. Oh, for this week, I will see you again next week. And she has guaranteed me that we are going to come with a comeback. Watch out for that. Thank you so much for watching. And take care of yourselves, but most importantly, take care of each other. Peace.